Hello my lovelies, it's Helen here. Welcome back to my channel and to today's video. So you probably found this video after watching my remove and resculpting video which I uploaded prior to this one. And if you haven't watched that one, I will link it up here in the cards for you so you can watch whenever you like. In the meantime, let me show you how I created today's design. With a metallic gel polish and a liner brush, I'm adding random dots to the pinky and allowing this gel polish to air dry before curing it. In the meantime, I'm moving over to the pointer finger and just placing two random black gel polish lines across the nail as you see here. And then I'm swapping over brushes to my 3D brush dipped in some isopropyl alcohol, and I'm patting at the two lines. It's this actual patting motion along with the alcohol in the brush that helps me disperse and dilute the two black gel polish lines which I had on the nail. By cleaning and re-dipping your brush in some alcohol, you can go back into your lines and actually remove more gel polish and make it look even more transparent than before. Don't cure that one just yet and move on to getting some black gel polish, and then go back, starting off with the pinky and adding a black border around all the gold dots. Use a fine liner brush and just draw random, either a random circle around the entire gold dot, or I like to break it up and make it look as uneven as possible because we're trying to imitate what leopard spots look like, and they're definitely not symmetrical or even. Once you've circumferenced all the gold dots, then go back in between each of them and just add random black dots in some sections and then random black C's in other sections. Once you're happy with the placement of all your black detail, then you can cure this section on this hand for a full minute in your LED light. In the meantime, we can move on to the other hand and do exactly the same thing. I'm starting off on the pointer finger, again with the two random black lines, and then diluting them with some isopropyl alcohol. Acetone is also a great substitute if you don't have any isopropyl alcohol. And if you happen to stuff up and take away too much of the design, just go back in with some black gel polish again in the section where you want to re-add it, and then tap away even more gently with even less product. I'm going to cure the second hand and then move back to the first hand, and on top of the original faded lines I'm going to use some black gel polish, a very fine detail liner brush, and add in some black wavy veins to this marble nail look. Now this is where your imagination comes in, and you can draw these lines wherever you see fit in the design. If you find you're having difficulty visualizing a marble pattern, go buy a reference from a photo and follow that design. I've done this marble design quite a few times, and this is my favorite placement of the veins, and I feel it looks the most marble-ish, if you will, and I really do like the way it comes out. So I'm just using my liner brush and some black gel polish and drawing some extra fine lines in amongst the other lines which I drew. I'm just showing you here again on the other hand and how I'm just randomly drawing these lines. And keep in mind, the line placement of this particular step where we're drawing in the veins will absolutely depend on how you diluted your previous lines before this step. So do follow what you think flows with what you have already diluted previously, and try and use the black lines to highlight and enhance what your diluted line work was. I've cured my black line work that I was happy with, and now I'm using the same gold gel polish that I used for the leopard to add some accent veins into this marble nail design. This can be as random or as specific as you want, and if by chance you happen to add too much gold and you don't like the way the nail is looking, you can always go back and add in some black gel polish over the gold that you didn't like I just did here, to sort of make it look a little less dominant, and continue about your design as normal. Once you're happy with the design and how all your line work is looking, you can flash cure it or cure it for a full minute in your LED light, and then continue on to the bling stage of the nails. This is by far my favorite step of all my design work, and I'm using Miss Yu's jewelry gel to attach my crystals. So with a gel brush, you apply the product onto the nail and make sure you're not too liberal but not too scanty with it. And then before you cure it or even apply any crystals, you apply a no wipe top coat over the jewelry gel. This will make sure the tacky layer is gone once you've cured your crystals in the LED light. So with a no wipe top coat in place, I am adding random crystals, and these crystals are by Sarah Burchett. You all know Sarah from her YouTube channel, Nails by Sarah Burchett. And obviously, if you follow her, you will know that she's come out with Swarovski packs. This is the Winter Sparkle Swarovski pack that she put together personally. And I was lucky enough to get a pack because there's only limited amounts. So keep an eye out whenever she puts out any products, they're always limited amounts and you've got to be one of the first in to get it, otherwise you miss out. And I was really happy to get a hand of this one because they are absolutely stunning. And being a nail tech herself, she knows exactly what crystals need to go in a pack to make it work. And I'm really happy with this one. You can see I'm in crystal heaven, applying crystals to my heart's content. And the good thing about jewelry gel is that it allows you to place and move crystals if you're not happy with their position. So you don't have to cure it up until you're completely 100% happy with their placement. And once you do, they're set in place. And here is the completed look, my lovelies. What do you think of it? Be sure to let me know down below in the comments what you thought of this design. If you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any future videos I put out. So that's it for today's video. I will see you all in my next video. But in the meantime, if you would like to watch another one, YouTube recommends this one for you, while I recommend this one. Which one will you choose? I'll see you all next time. Bye.